So hi everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB Current Affairs, where we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news which are relevant for all the government exams, whether it is central government exam or the state government exam or the banking exam. So guys, ab Diwali khatam ho chuki hai, so it's time that you should get back to work and jo bhi celebration ka time tha ab nikal chuka hai. I believe ki aap logo ki Diwali bahut achhi rahi hogi. I hope so. And regarding sessions, मैं आपको बताना चाहता हूँ कि in this week the sessions will be conducted regularly. That is Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and I will try to take one more session on Saturday also. This way we will cover up all the backlog, जो भी दिवाली की वजह से backlog हुआ था, that I will cover by taking sessions regularly. All right. So let's begin with the session. But before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to the channel and press this bell icon. You can also join this Telegram group. Here you will get the PDF of this session after the session is completed. And you can also follow me on Instagram. This is my Instagram ID. You can also follow me here and you can also ask any question here. So let's talk about the very first question, which says, consider the following statements with respect to Bhasha Sangam initiative and you have to identify the correct statement. Bhasha Sangam initiative launch hua tha, uske respect mein aapko correct statement identify karna hai. Remember, this initiative has been launched by Ministry of Education headed by Dharmendra Pradhan. Alright, so let's discuss what is the news. Union Education Minister Mr. Dharmendra Pradhan has launched Bhasha Sangam initiative under Ek Bharat Shrestha Bharat initiative. Alright, and do remember this initiative has been launched to inculcate basic conversational skills among the citizens of India in an Indian language which is other than their mother tongue. जैसे मेरी मदर टंग, अगर मान लो कि एक्स मेरी मदर टंग है, तो उसके अलावा अगर मेरी उसके अलावा मुझे किसी और लैंग्वेज में कुछ कॉन्वर्सेशनल स्किल सीखना चाहता हूं, तो उसके लिए दिस इनिशिएटिव भाषा संगम हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एजुकेशन. एंड देर आर थ्री डिफरेंट इनिशिएटिव्स विच हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड अंडर भाषा संगम. नंबर वन इज भाषा संगम इनिशिएटिव फॉर स्कूल. दिस इज फॉर स्कूल किड्स. ठीक है, this has been developed by NCERT and this is available on Diksha platform, on e-Pathshala platform, and there are 22 separate booklets for all for this. In this program, 100 sentences are framed in 22 scheduled language, in Devanagari script, in Roman script, and the translations into Hindi and English are also available so that the person can identify what he or she is reading. And then with the help of this, learners in school will be able to get acquainted with all the languages, their scripts and their pronunciation. Second initiative is Bhasha Sangam mobile app. Remember, this initiative is of the Department of Higher Education and MyGov platform. And this app has been developed by a startup which is known as Multibhashi. Very, very important. You should remember the name of this startup. Multibhashi is the name of the startup and it also consists of 100 sentences in 22 scheduled languages. All right. And number three initiative is Ek Bharat Shrestha Bharat quiz app. All right. And through this quiz game, children and youngsters can learn about our different regions, states, cultures, national heroes, monuments, etc. And this game, guys, is currently available in English and Hindi. But in the upcoming 3 months, it will be available in 12 other different regional languages. All right. So this was about this news and now let's come back to the question. So you have to identify the correct statement. Bhasha Sangam initiative for schools has been developed by CBSE. No, that's not CBSE, that's NCERT. Bhasha Sangam mobile app has been developed by a startup known as Multilingual. That is not multilingual, that's Multibhashi. Alright. And the initiative has been launched by Ministry of Culture. No, that has been launched by Ministry of Education. So all the statements are incorrect, which means option E. None is correct, guys, will be the correct answer. Moving ahead to question number two. What was the theme of the 6th edition of Ayurveda Day that was observed on 2nd of November? Ayurveda Day, guys, is observed on the occasion of Dhanteras. Because Dhanteras is the birthday of Dhanvantri, which is regarded as the god of Ayurveda. And that is why Dhanteras is observed as the Ayurveda Day. And this year, Dhanteras was on 2nd November and that's why the Ayurveda Day was also on 2nd November. So the question is regarding the theme. Remember guys, the theme was Ayurveda for Poshan. Ayurveda for Poshan, and during the event, a film which has been made by Central Council of Research in Ayurveda Sciences on scientific achievements in the field of Ayurveda Poshan has been announced, and this film will be launched very soon. And Ayurveda Swasthya Samiksha booklet and Ayurveda for Poshan document were also launched at the event. The most important part in this news is this theme. And also remember that this was the 6th edition. Ayurveda for Poshan was the theme. And who is the Minister of Ayush, by the way? It's Mr. Sarbanand Sonowal. So, option B, Ayurveda for Poshan is the correct answer because they are asking the theme only. Question number 3 pe chalte hai. Where has Uttarakhand's first internet exchange been inaugurated? कहाँ पे उत्तराखंड का पहला इंटरनेट एक्सचेंज इनॉग्रेट हुआ है? रिमेंबर दिस इज नेशनल इंटरनेट एक्सचेंज इंडियाज 10th इंटरनेट एक्सचेंज. दिस कंपनी गाइस प्रोवाइड्स इंटरनेट सर्विसेज टू द सिटीजंस एंड रिमेंबर इट इज अ नॉट फॉर प्रॉफिट कंपनी और यू कैन से इट इज अ सेक्शन 8 कंपनी अंडर द कंपनीज एक्ट ऑफ 2013. ऑलराइट, एंड फॉर द वेरी फर्स्ट टाइम इन उत्तराखंड दिस इंटरनेट एक्सचेंज हैज बीन इनॉग्रेटेड इन देहरादून. Option A, Dehradun is the correct answer to this question. Moving ahead to question number 4, and of course Dehradun is the capital of Uttarakhand. I hope you all know this. Which of the following countries is not a part of basic group of countries? Now this question guys belongs to the static part. This is a static question, but basic group of countries ka bhi meeting hua tha. There was a meeting of basic group of countries environment ministers, right? And that's why it is in news. So I thought ki isse रिलेटेड एक क्वेश्चन रख लेना चाहिए. सो बेसिक ग्रुप ऑफ कंट्रीज कंसिस्ट ऑफ गाइज ब्राजील साउथ अफ्रीका इंडिया एंड चाइना. सो दीज आर द 4 कंट्रीज इन द बेसिक ग्रुप ऑफ कंट्रीज एक्सेप्ट ऑस्ट्रेलिया. ऑप्शन बी, ऑस्ट्रेलिया इज नॉट देयर. ऑप्शन बी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. क्वेश्चन नंबर 5 पे चलते हैं. विद विच इंटरनेशनल बैंक गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया हैज साइंड एन अग्रीमेंट वर्थ $40 million फॉर इंप्रूविंग द क्वालिटी ऑफ हेल्थ सर्विसेज इन द स्टेट ऑफ मेघालय. मेघालय चीफ मिनिस्टर गाइस इज कॉन्राड संगमा इज द चीफ मिनिस्टर ऑफ मेघालय एंड दिस इंटरनेशनल बैंक रिमेंबर इज वर्ल्ड बैंक. ऑप्शन डी वर्ल्ड बैंक. एंड इन दिस टाइप ऑफ न्यूज आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू सो मेनी टाइम्स दैट यू जस्ट हैव टू रिमेंबर 2-3 थिंग्स. नंबर 1, यू हैव टू रिमेंबर द नेम ऑफ द बैंक. यू हैव टू रिमेंबर द पर्पज ऑफ द लोन, दैट इज फॉर इंप्रूविंग द क्वालिटी ऑफ हेल्थ सर्विस. यू हैव टू रिमेंबर द स्टेट फॉर विच दिस लोन इज टेकन एंड यू हैव टू रिमेंबर द अमाउंट ऑफ द लोन. सो दीज 4 थिंग्स you have to remember: the bank, the state, the purpose, and the amount. All right. So here, the World Bank is the correct answer. David Malpass is the chief of World Bank. David Malpass and Carmen Reinhart is the CFO. I believe he is the CFO of World Bank. Question number 6: Which of the following IITs has developed Ganga Atlas, which documents the changes in River Ganga over the past 5-6 decades? Now this, remember this Ganga Atlas has been launched during the Ganga Utsav. During the Ganga Utsav, the 5th edition of Ganga Utsav, which was inaugurated by Union Minister for Jal Shakti, which is headed by Mr. Gajendra Singh Shekhawat. Gajendra Singh Shekhawat's Lok Sabha constituency guys is Jodhpur. Okay. So this was the 5th edition of Ganga Utsav and there were various launches. Like number 1, continuous learning activity portal has been launched. Now this portal guys is a platform to facilitate debates and discussions and express ideas on various issues pertaining to environment, water, rivers, etc. It has been developed by NMCG in association with Tree Craze Foundation and it is also being supported and funded by World Bank. Theek hai, isme World Bank ka bhi support hai. Number 2, that NMCG, National Mission for Clean Ganga, has made a Guinness World Record for most photos of handwritten notes uploaded to Facebook in 1 hour. And these handwritten notes are regarding Save Ganga. Save Ganga ke regarding a handwritten notes se. And in 1 hour, most photos of handwritten notes uploaded to Facebook in 1 hour. The Guinness World Record has been made by NMCG. And then Ganga Atlas, River of the Past. This atlas has been launched by, has been developed by IIT Kanpur. And this atlas documents the changes in River Ganga over the past 5-6 decades. Alright. So this was about this news and hence the correct answer of this question guys is what? IIT Kanpur, option C. Moving ahead to question number 7. Name the digital health card which will be provided to all the Hajj pilgrims going for Hajj in 2022. See guys, now I have started taking all the questions. Like agar question koi chota hai ya question bada hai, so I have started taking all the questions because these days I have observed that in the examination they are asking anything. So कुछ क्वेश्चंस ऐसे हैं जिनकी क्वालिटी आई बिलीव बहुत अच्छी नहीं है, बट दे आर ऑल्सो, बट दीज क्वेश्चंस आर ऑल्सो आर बीइंग आस्क्ड इन द एग्जाम. सो दैट्स व्हाई मुझे भी लेने पड़ रहे हैं. बहुत ज्यादा डिटेल में हम उन क्वेश्चंस के नहीं जाएंगे लाइक दिस क्वेश्चन, और इसके अलावा जो हमने ये वाला क्वेश्चन देखा था अभी बेसिक ग्रुप ऑफ कंट्रीज वाला, इंडिया फर्स्ट उत्तराखंड फर्स्ट इंटरनेट एक्सचेंज वाला, सो इन सच क्वेश्चंस वी शुड नॉट गो इनटू द डिटेल्स, वी जस्ट शुड स्टिक टू द क्वेश्चन जो भी हमारा इसमें क्वेश्चन बन सकता है. ऑलराइट, सो नेम द डिजिटल हेल्थ कार्ड दैट विल बी प्रोवाइडेड टू द हज पिलग्रिम्स गोइंग फॉर हज इन 2022. वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन. द ई मसीहा इज द नेम ऑफ डिजिटल हेल्थ कार्ड विच विल बी प्रोवाइडेड टू ऑल द हज पिलग्रिम्स हु आर गोइंग फॉर हज इन द ईयर 2022. ई मसीहा इज द करेक्ट आंसर. सो लेट्स मूव अहेड टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 8, विच इज द लास्ट क्वेश्चन फॉर टुडे. विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग पीएसयूज अंडर द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ पावर हैज ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बिजली उत्सव. नाउ रिमेंबर दिस बिजली उत्सव वॉज ऑर्गेनाइज्ड टू स्प्रेड अवेयरनेस रिगार्डिंग द बेनिफिट्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी एंड इट्स कंजर्वेशन. Benefits of electricity and its conservation, and also to spread awareness about various government schemes like Swabhagya, Sahaj Bijli Har Ghar Yojana, etc. Alright, and this PSU guys remember is REC Limited, option C, Rural Electrification Corporation. This is of course a PSU under Ministry of Power headed by Mr. R.K. Singh, and it is headquartered in New Delhi. Alright, and that's it for the session guys. For today, I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. And milte hain kal ke session mein. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.